Hey y'all, this is Cheryl, and thanks for joining me for another digital scrapbooking process video. I'm going to be scrapping some photos of a family dinner, a Sunday dinner, that my mom had back in October. And I'll be using an older collab by Sweet Shop Designs. And I'm going to start out with the photos. I'm using five of them. And I'm just pulling on some journal cards. And I'm not sure which ones I'm going to use, but you can see that I have put the portrait photos kind of two of them together and then one of them at a diagonal. And then the two landscape photos are at a diagonal. So I'm just going to start moving some of these journal cards. And I have reduced their size because I want to kind of use them as word art rather than actual journal cards. So I am going to be trying to fit quite a bit on this page. Now these photos are from October and there was no special occasion. We just hadn't gotten together in a while. My sister had been traveling quite a bit and we had not seen each other, so my mom said that she would cook. And the meal we had was something that my sister had wanted for a while, and mom made fried pork chops and a pasta salad, rice, tomato gravy, and then for dessert we had peach cobbler with ice cream. And my mom is a fabulous cook. I just she loves to cook and she's good at it. And we always enjoy being at her house because she sets a beautiful table as well. One of the photos that you can see there, the close-up of the peach cobbler, you can see the dishes that she used called, they're called Strawberry Fair, I think. Anyway, she collects lots of different sets of dishes and she likes to put them out. And usually she'll have a centerpiece, like, you know, flower arrangement or something from her garden. And I don't think she did this time. Or if she did, we already moved it off so we could put all the food on the table and I didn't take a picture of it. So this is just, I think we had gone to church that morning and Olivia was at university, so she just met us. She's about 20 minutes away. And my sister came over from Pensacola. And then, of course, my grandma was there, and she's 90. So you can see her in the photo. It's like a group selfie up at the top right. There's all of us sitting around the table. So I've just kind of, you know, moved the different journal cards around. And I've added a couple of pieces of washi tape. I'm just going to reduce their size just a tad. And I've added some word strips and what will end up being my title at the top right, the family dinner chalkboard label. And now I'm adding some stamps. And really, there is no rhyme or reason to what I added onto this page. I was actually in a Google Hangout with a fellow DigiScrapper, so we were busy just chatting our little hearts away. So if you see me pause during this video, it's because we're talking. And you'll have to excuse me. The pollen count must be insane here right now. When I go outside, my car is like covered with yellow. And you can hear my son in the background. He's coughing. Because he has allergies too. So that's why we all sound a little funny. So excuse us for that. But hopefully it will just stay allergies. We're taking our allergy medicine. And I hope that we won't succumb to anything more severe, like sinus infection or bronchitis or something. Fingers crossed on that. I love Florida during the spring, but oh, it is miserable if you have allergies that are seasonal. So another reason why I'm glad to say that I am not an outdoorsy person. I do enjoy being inside. I like being comfortable, and I don't like to sweat. So in Florida, we have very few weeks of the year where you can actually enjoy being outside for any length of time, and usually those are during the early spring and the fall. The rest of the time, it's like miserably hot. And actually, during the winter, you can be outside a little bit, but there is one picture of my mom here, and she has a broom, and I did crop it, so you just see her holding on to it, but I took it as a funny haha, you know, look at her, she's got her broom. Anyway, I had to take that part out, but I thought my mom looked really good. And what is so strange, I mean, she cooks this huge meal for us. I think she had even been outside sweeping when we went on the carport and we're talking. Excuse me, I had to mute so I could cough. She looks really healthy, but the very next day we she had picked up my son for me from school because I had a doctor's appointment with a neurosurgeon. And when I came to pick up Daniel, it had been raining quite a bit. And so they had gotten cold and wet. And she looked really tired, but she seemed to feel fine. And I had not been gone an hour and a half when she called, and she was not doing very well at all. She had started shaking all over, and we ended up having to call 911, or she did, and then by the time I arrived at her house, the fire department was there, and then the ambulance was shortly behind. But it turns out she had a septic infection, and which could have been really bad. She could have ended up in intensive care and had, you know, the potential for damage to the brain. But we were so blessed. We got her to the hospital so quickly. So I'm so glad we had this just normal everyday dinner. Of course, I love spending time with my family, but even more that memory, you know, this day is really special because of how, you know, intense the next, you know, week to 10 days was. And then even further than that, she had to continue antibiotic treatment. So, you know, just be with your family, enjoy them, and make sure you take lots of pictures, because you never know. Like, we had no clue, she didn't look sick or anything, that the very next day she would be in the hospital and she would be there all week. Anyway, I've added flowers, buttons, flair, string. I'm really trying to pull everything together, balancing color out. Not necessarily working in a triangle, but sometimes it does turn out that way. Just want to pull your eye from spot to spot. And I'm just really loving word strips lately. I really like the little bit that it adds. I'll be doing my journaling off camera, but pretty much I'll just be describing everything I shared with y'all already in the video. And you'll see the completed layouts coming up here. Of course, if you like the video, please be sure to give me a thumbs up and, of course, share. And I'd love for you to subscribe so you don't miss any videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Happy scrapping!